as Alex has already told you, I'm working on the 3D graphics stuff. And master student in the University of Chile. So this is a for motivation, this is an old demo that was originally written with Golden 1, but it has already been ported into Golden 2 using Golden Rosen. Only this something like 8 lines of code, and we have 20,000 cubes. There are some pauses sometimes that I think that is because of the garbage collector. So we can see that this is really fast. So that is for motivation. This talk is about the development of Golden 2, and is divided in two parts. The first part is about the foundation elements for Golden. First, trying to ask the question of why I'm rewriting Golden, because I had to rewrite the full from scratch, mostly because of problems with OpenGL, and from time to time I was receiving an email of someone telling me that I was not working on his computer and I was not able to solve his problem because I didn't have, or I don't have sometimes a computer with the same graphics card or a graphics card with the same manufacturer. I'm going to talk a bit about the model PC architecture. And model is in quotation because this is actually after the 90s. So, abstraction layers. The abstract GPU is an abstraction layer about low-level graphics API. The Dustrel, the data stream language, is a custom C language whose compiler is written in Faro and is able to generate. Well, this generates an SSA intermediate representation for that is similar to LLVM. That is after that compiled into the shared language that is used by the low-level graphics API. In some cases, such as Vulkan, is a one-to-one mapping on this low-level intermediate representation. The second part is about Golden 2 itself. I'm going to talk really short about the Golden Mask library, the core, then some convenience, or actually these basic layers for the user to use. Then I will talk about the applications that I made with Golden 2. And if we have some more time, I will try to show more demos in that point. So why I'm rewriting Golden 2? Well, this is my run list against OpenGL. So OpenGL is really complex. We have several versions, all of them. And when one has to write a 3D application using OpenGL, one has to choose at least one minimal version from there. And each one of these versions also has a completely different, well, not completely different, but sometimes very different shared language for programming the graphics card. Also, OpenGL drivers are good pile. Some of them follow the specification of OpenGL, some of them don't. So that's why sometimes I receive some emails with one and one of people complaining that it's not working on this laptop and it's working on mine, on the laptop of another person. And each OpenGL call uses a brief local variable for sending the commands. And that does not behave at all well with Faro processes. And when we will change in Faro to OS window using SDL2 that is internally using OpenGL, sometimes we can have some problems with when we try to run into an OpenGL window, but it could run into the main Faro window. And the GLSL, the shared language of OpenGL, is written in the driver. So each version of the driver has its own bugs and different behavior, which is really annoying. A shader is a short plan that runs in the GPU. So here we have a diagram of the graphics API pipeline. by sending some comments into the video.
You can take the microphone. Take the microphone.
Okay. Thank you. Sorry about that. Okay, so we have the CPU that sends some comments by calling one API call that is sent into the GPU, that is implicitly written into a command buffer. It's slash CPU because the GPU is actually has many processors. One of them is the command processor that receives this command and dispatch the word to the GPU. The GPU receives these commands, some primitives, some geometric information. They are executed by a shader that computes things like lighting in these primitives, and then they are rendered into a canvas. The shader is a short program that like the one that makes things look really pretty. So in a modern PC, we have a CPU, a RAM, the graphics card, a bus that connects them, and between these bus, we have something that most of the people does not know, that is the I/O memory management unit. This is one piece of hardware that allows the CPU to write directly to the memory space of the GPU, and it also allows the GPU to write directly to the memory space of the CPU. In other words, this allows us to communicate with the CPU by just writing into some special memory pointers, which is something that with the old or the classic graphics API we cannot do because it's not exposed. So this is how it looks, the new modern graphics API, Vulkan, the DirectX 12, and Metal. The CPU writes the commands into a command list. The command list references a descriptor set, something that is like a table with pointers that says which uniform, vertex, index, buffer. So these two things describe the geometry, vertices, and how they are linked. And this thing describes arbitrary parameters such as the position of the camera, the lighting color, anything that the program wants. Textures such as how that wall looks. The pipeline state object, it encapsulates all of the rendering state in an immutable object. It encapsulates the shaders, how the depth testing, how we say if one object is in front of another object, and how transparency is computing, among other things, in this immutable object. And this command list can also be reused. So when one is writing, is calling a graphics API, the expensive part is actually building this command list. So in the case of OpenGL, the raw elements, which is a call that uses how much triangles it has to go as and where they are, the thing that is most expensive. But here, it can cost almost nothing because you complete that the results of that call and then you just reuse it. The reason because it is expensive is because the API has to perform lots of validations. With this new low-level graphics API, we can avoid about all of these validations by just reusing this command buffer and this pipeline objects. And since we can memory map these buffers for updating data, so if we change the camera, we just write the new camera position in the uniform buffer with the that holds the camera, and then the GPU will just see the update. This allows us to reduce CPU consumption and to have many objects and really fast. For big objects, you usually perform a DMA transfer. You say, this is the data, copy it from the CPU to the GPU. Or RapidCPI, they only expose this kind of data transfer. So for the core abstraction layers are the abstract view, the data abstraction language, exploring the Smalltalk low-level virtual machine, which is something similar to LLVM but just in the intermediate representation and to generate the what Vulkan expects. And also it allows me to have one version of the shaders compared to the different backends. And because the shader compiler that came with the Vulkan SDK was incomplete. So the abstract GPU is this abstraction layer about Vulkan Metal XPD12. It has an API that I in C that is inspired by the API of OpenCL. I mean that each function call receives a pointer with the handle of the object. It is implemented on C++. And it also provides some convenience in some minor abstraction that is between OpenGL and Vulkan, but mostly for bookkeeping and allocating resources and transferring them. The next spec for generating the JQs and the bindings, and this is mostly tested using Vulkan in Linux. But the implementation from the XPD12 and Metal, they are almost complete, they are not yet tested. The case of Metal, it only works on the 64-bit version of the application, and 32-bit version it does not work. So we need a 64-bit version of the FarVM for that. The DustRail, Data Stream Language, is a custom shader language whose compiler is written in Faro. It is a static type language. It has types, but they are in fear locally. So for Bitcoin arrival, usually I don't write the type. This was intended to be a semi-visual programming language, but it is only non-visual. And it does not use the classic C syntax. This is how a shader that produces a software with a single color and it is lighted. It looks like. So that's the normal for computing illumination. This is the view vector of how one is looking for doing some reflection computation. Then it drags the color into the fragment output. And it calls another clock that does the electric computation. This part is for declaring the interface in between the GPU and the CPU by declaring data structure layouts and how they are connected. That part looks very similar to what you have in GLSL or other shader languages. And this is a Kruger function. So the backend is inspired on LLVM. In terms that it uses the same kind of SSA intermediate representation, it has some very basic optimizations. The cool thing is that it has a backend for SpearBeam, which is the intermediate representation used by Vulkan, and it uses almost a one-to-one mapping between these two. This thing works really fast and in theory, it should be possible to adapt a small talk of file for being used to program the GPU directly, but the problem is that we need a programming mod, we need to adapt it to the programming mod and the different architecture. So the backends, the GLSL is used by OpenGL, and there is a compile from GLSL to Vulkan, the SDK of Vulkan, but it's incomplete. HLSL is used by D3D or this version, and this one is used by Metal. In the case of Metal, the Metal shader language is actually C++ with some minor modifications. So So now I'm going to be talking about Woden to itself. And in first place we have the Woden math library. It's a basic 3D graphics linear algebra math library with 2D, 3D, 4D vectors, some other stuff for computing geometrical transformations. And the important thing is that this is written in Faro, but in a special way. That way. So here I'm using slots with a constant structure layout that makes it behave exactly as a C structure, and it also allows me to just copy the data to the memory in the GPU. This is one of the things that allows me to get a bit more performance. There are some type of notation that used to generate special bytecodes. In Thursday, I will be explaining more about this in a WSD paper talk. As for the Woden 2 core, there's the Woden 2 engine, which contains these two caches, one for that loads all of the pipeline state object, which shares all of them, all of this rendering state at initialization time. Then they are just reused. The resource cache for loading resources from files, from the file system, should just load in once, and they only will be one, the memory once. Some wrappers allow the actual GPU for being able to save an image and being able to restore it, but it's not the tested that part. So right now, if you say Woden 2 image and it has some Woden 2 window, especially using Morphe, it could crash if you reopen it. I think that part is tested. Some utilities, a custom build platform format that is far more friendly with the GPU than FreeType. This is actually just a huge test with Apigas or the deja vu font and Unicode font that I just operate to the GPU and then I just reuse it. Tools for building jump meshes, geometry. And this is a structure that matches exactly the structure that I use in the GPU. This is the low level stuff. Also, the user will not have to deal with this, and they will have some slight move on this way that you will in the end. Also, the user will have to deal with the SYNGAF. We have this special node for describing geometry. There are two versions, one that is a complete object and another version that is a group of objects that are similar, all in different locations, but the same shape, which are faster to render. The camera and the light source. This is how it looks. The code for making an scene with a cube. I will show it later, how it looks like. Then there is the scene render that takes care about rendering a scene. Currently I'm using an algorithm that is called forward rendering that just traverses around each one of the objects and it logs them. It puts the blown comments into the comment list and it will just use it. Before recording the command list, it will check if something was changed on the topology for being able to reuse the command list. This thing made a huge deal in performance, especially in the level editor. Shadows are not yet implemented. That is something that I have to do. And the first thing is another rendering algorithm that separates geometry from lighting. It basically allows you to have thousands of lights. Currently the limit is 16 lights. I also have a custom Athens backend. So we can use the Athens API using Woden 2 and to render directly into the graphics card. And this thing is fast. Here we see only 60 frames per second because there is a FPS fluctuate about eating up the whole CPU. But if I remove it, I can get something like 500 frames per second. This was the introduction demo, the motivation demo of the Golden Curosa, where you can view some 3D scene using short code like snippets with interaction and everything. And there is the Golden Two game system that was what I showed yesterday. The Golden Curosa and the game system, they are built about the scene graph. They usually don't deal with the low level stuff. They just take care of updating the scene graph and choosing the modifications into it. And of course, the level editor. These buttons from here are actually from Block. They have been rendered using the custom Athens backend. So, that's where Golden 2D is located. It can be a button. Unfortunately, it requires a custom VM because of the Golden Maths library optimization. But these changes into the VM, they will be integrated into the main FAR VM. And it will be just able, and you will be just able to use MetaShell before loading it in the near future. So now I think that is the time that everybody was expecting, demo time. So here we have the demo of the scene with the single view. We're using the spectro. Or modify, for example, the LED color, if I find this in. So here. So, LED source. So, I think I need this one. So, density. So, the writing that. So, why is it this state? Is this a special object? WT, vector data, which is using this. So, this is actually see like a structure written in Faro that is just copied into the graphics card, and the shader, it just reads this data. If I play to, so since I'm using the inspector, this is using the modified OPI compiler for generating the bytecode. So if I try to present some object to a message with a different thing, I will just get a tech error. But it is because I am using the spectrum with this kind of object. For most of the normal carriers, you will use the normal compiler that does not perform this test at compile time. So, the level editor is inspired in the level editor that is used in the Half-Life video game. The user interface. So in that level editor, one selects one cube and one press enter to build it. So I can and move it under. These 2D views are actually 3D views, but instead of using a perspective projection, they're using an orthographic projection. So I'm just rendering the same scene for the 2D views. Of course, it's not very impressive if you don't add some light there. These buttons from here are actually from block, and the layout of this window is also made with block. Each one of these views, of these four views, they are actually a block that is fully transparent. So I'm using the block for positioning the viewport and also for handling events. So the React event that I'm using here is actually the block React event. So I'm gonna add some point. Well, this has the same volume that a player should have. And we're gonna put it in play mode to see how a building could look. Now I added another object. The represents square a gun. Of course, since this is in a small talk, unlike other buildings, same, I can just change. Some behaviors. So I'm gonna make the bullet slower and without, but I'm gonna remove first the gravity and I'm gonna make it slower. Shoot this bullet 2 meters per second. So, any questions? Meanwhile, the next person is getting installed. So, probably I should show the... is working in Phoenix. Let's go.
Yeah, Ronnie.
Yeah.
I have a question, like maybe a very naive question, but I dare ask it. How far are we from making a super cool 3D games, you know, like such as you can see with Unity, I don't know what. So how far are we from that?
Not very far away. The biggest
really,
we are not very far away, but our biggest problem is on the VM, because we are not able to take advantage of the multiple CPU cores. Our VM is single-threaded, and it's really hard to make it really multi-threaded. And I think that multi-threading is going to have some overhead. But after being able to surpass that thing, and I also think that we can do some really cool compiler stuff by doing some ahead of time compiler and our own compiler framework here in Faron. We could have even better performance and more flexibility than current video game engines. So I think that if we have something like LLVM, we would maybe mixing Smalltalk and C-Bake code with almost no overhead, and for the performance stuff, people just use it in a single environment. that's something that I really would like to play with. And I have already some early experience with the small talk boiler filter machine, when I had an experimental over compiler backend, when I'm using this SSI form and directly to C++ code, and some experiments with machine code generation.
I used the previous version of your GPU, and there was a lot of problem when I switched from one version to another version of macOS 10.
Yes, I got a look at that problem. I think that me and Wally can be the rest of the talk. I think that I will fix it by this evening.
Okay. And so the new version of Visual GPU?
It's not the different GPU, the actual GPU. The Visual GPU, for the people that does not know, is a DSL about OpenCL for parallel computing and parallel algorithm. And I was going to ask you if you can already look on that on the Maro bindings. So I think that those will be all the people of yours already start getting here. So that we have this backend. And if I remove the frames per second limiter, I comment this line. Well, sometimes you can see something that looks like a 500, but so this is something really fascinating.